The ID Tech X show right here with BrightVault. And who are you?
James Pope, Vice President of Power Solutions.
So what are we looking at here? This is a flexible battery?
A thin, flexible, ultra-thin film battery. So uses would be things like powered cards, medical patches, sensors, smart labels, areas where very thin, very flexible cells are required. Something that you can get a nice radius and good bend on the cell.
So this could be in a smart, like some kind of smartwatch, maybe?
Could be in a smartwatch, could be in a number of different applications where the conventional cells, like the coin cells and things like that, just don't have a play. But you can put very small, thin cells that require flexibility. You can put them in watch bands, as an example, something like this, where you could actually bend it around a watch band, take the battery out of the main, out of the watch itself, shrink down the thickness. Medical patches, as an example, where the patch might have to go on an arm, where there has to be a little bit of flexibility around the cell, but still delivers good power, good reliability, very safe.
Safe?
A lot of neat applications.
How about in clothes?
You know, it's interesting. I've had several people contact me doing textiles that are looking to possibly build these batteries into clothing. Some of the larger names you might hear that are putting them into the backs of, say, jackets, gloves, places where they still need to, they need power. But today, the batteries are just too thick.
Yeah. And you have very small ones like this also?
Yes, we can do custom sizes. So besides the more conventional sizes we make, we can also make some very thin sizes. Very small cells with a little bit lower capacity, but still, very robust, still flexible. So we can do a lot of custom sizes. And besides being able to do the primary non-rechargeable product, we also have rechargeable cells that we're beginning to work on as well. So we will also be able to handle the secondary rechargeable cells besides the primary non-rechargeable cells.
So right now it's non-rechargeable?
Not rechargeable at this time, but that is in our lab. Our chief scientist and his group are working on that today. And so very shortly we will have rechargeable batteries as well, and we can do custom form factors on the rechargeable sizes also.
Custom what?
Custom form factors. So besides the form factors you see here, someone might come to us and say, can you make something a little larger, a little thicker? We can do custom sizes in both chemistries.
So it's a polymer matrix electrolyte technology?
Yes.
How does that work compared to lithium ion?
The polymer matrix electrode is our own proprietary way of building a cell. So we have patents on this technology today. So the way it's layered, is again proprietary, so it's a much safer way to build a battery. Two components instead of three. So, for example, for medical patches, where the FDA is an example, is very interested in very safe product, something that's up against the human skin and like a class 2 device. They want something that they know is not going to have any problems at all. You can tear this battery.
You can put a needle through it.
You know what? I don't know if you can see this, but check this out. I just want to show this to you really quick. But as an example, in the lab, you have situations where we're testing, the open circuit voltage at 3 volts per cell. Normally, hitting a battery with a hammer, bad idea.
Yeah.
But after testing the battery, still back up to 3 volts per cell. And just for fun, really quick, he's gonna go back at it again. Beaten the battery several times, but that battery is still going to function like it did originally because of the way it's designed. It is much more robust and much safer than what you would find in any conventional cell.
That's awesome. So how about when it's rechargeable, how many recharge can it do?
Goal will be to be to the 300 to 500 cycles, just like you would find in your conventional rechargeable cells, but you will also still have the ability to flex the battery. So the flexibility is what most of our customers are looking for, besides just the ability to get the same voltage at 3.6, 3.7, the same types of capacities that they see today.
What's the all capacity?
Capacities can run all over the place, but we're going to probably start with something in like the 50 milliamps up to 600, 700, 800. But if someone came to us and said, I want a 2 amp hour battery, we could still manufacture that, give them the capacity they need and a safer battery, but still give them that level of flexibility they need for things like clothing.
Because I'm a big guy and I'm wearing a big jacket.
Yes.
And so on my back could be at least 2,000 milliamp, right?
You could be up right into the shoulders, small the back, something that would come around a little bit. I was talking to a company earlier that was talking about building the battery into the clothing and then sealing it up so you could actually run it through the wash. Ways to encapsulate it so not only are you getting the power, but in places where you have to be able to wash it or it has to be water resistant, working with companies to develop technology to seal the battery so it's still functional.
No, it's not waterproof.
It is not waterproof, but it's not going to have a problem if it gets in water. That's, again, one of the unique characteristics of our PME. Again, as I mentioned before, you can actually tear one of these cells, drop it in water, and all you're going to get is a little fizzle. And generally speaking, with conventional lithium cells, you do not want those cells near water.
And so how long have you been doing this? And is it already out there?
A number of years. We have about 15 million cells out there in the marketplace today.
15 million.
We're shipping them into smart cards, smart labels, sensors, medical patches for pain management, which is a neat area. I mean, when you look at today where a lot of the pain management patches are drug, fentanyl type patches, something where you could slap a label on someone's arm and use the actual waveform as opposed to getting them potentially hooked on drugs, which is no good for anybody.
All right, so there's already 15 million
and
the future is going to be much more.
Much larger. I mean, I've had applications for people coming looking for smart labels now that number in the couple hundred million. So the applications for this are unlimited, but they can be some very large volumes.
There could be some cool display like e-ink, and then combined with your battery, and then you have a better, much better smart card for the bus and the subway.
Absolutely. Well, here's an example. I mean, take a look at this. Here's an example of a card. A bank, it's the same dimensions as a normal credit card. You press a button, there's your e-ink application where every time you press it, it gives you a two-factor identification.
It shows how much money you have on your bank.
Yeah, that would be nice, wouldn't it? Two-factor ID, but here you can see what this looks like internally. There's our cell, the circuit. That would be the guts of this, basically.
That's awesome. And this is the same size as a normal...
It has to be. So you could still, with the card swipe it right through the machines that you would normally use when you're purchasing items. So it fits right in there.
So how many millions did you ship of this one so far?
A number of millions. It's a good chunk of the 50.
It's already out there.
Yeah, it's not full blown at this point. There is a lot of this is still coming on board, but we have several people where we've shipped several very large orders. Correct. Yes.
And they have the displays and everything.
They have the displays. Yeah.
So this is really cool. It's awesome. All right. Cool. Thanks for making this kind of technology. We really need it.
Oh, you're very welcome. Thank you. Thank you for your time.